Welcome to Fix Sleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Amour Conspiracy at the Palace of Versailles. Chapter 1. Shadows of Intrigue. The Palace of Versailles' gilded facade was illuminated by silver light as the moon created an ethereal sheen over it. As Detective Victoria Hayes entered through the elaborate gates, a sensation of dread filled the chilly night air. As Victoria set off on her mysterious quest, the magnificence of Versailles stood as a silent witness to generations of secrets, and she could feel the weight of history bearing down on her. Her footsteps echoed through the deserted halls as she navigated the labyrinthine corridors of the palace. The opulence that surrounded her seemed to hide a multitude of sins, and the walls held the whispers of clandestine affairs and hidden agendas. Victoria's keen eyes scanned the tapestries and portraits that adorned the walls, searching for clues that might reveal the elusive conspiracy she had been tipped off about. The detective's investigation led her to the heart of the royal bloodline, where the power dynamics were as intricate as the gilded decorations that adorned the chambers. She moved through the shadows, her senses heightened, and her intuition guiding her like a compass through the sea of secrets. The scent of intrigue hung thick in the air, and Victoria could almost taste the tension that simmered beneath the surface. Victoria shuddered as she got closer to the royal library, a storehouse of wisdom and undiscovered facts. With the old documents illuminated by the flickering candlelight, the investigator started to put the jigsaw pieces together. In the dimly lighted passages, courtiers walked like phantoms with their extravagant costumes and powdered wigs, their whispered discussions hinting at betrayals and alliances. Victoria's investigation brought her to a forgotten chamber, tucked away behind a tapestry depicting a scene of royal splendor. The room was adorned with faded frescoes, and a solitary desk held a collection of letters sealed with the wax of noble houses. As she perused the correspondence, Victoria unraveled a network of clandestine meetings and coded messages that hinted at a plot to alter the course of history. The detective's sharp mind connected the dots, revealing a sinister undercurrent beneath the polished veneer of courtly life. It became evident that the stakes were higher than she had initially imagined, and the web of intrigue stretched beyond the palace walls. Victoria's mission became a race against time, a pursuit of truth through the corridors of power, where alliances shifted like sand and loyalties were as fragile as glass. As the evening wore on, Victoria discovered that she was drawn to the palace grounds because of the surreal glow that the moonlight cast on the surroundings. The sounds of whispering leaves seemed to be the voices of the past, calling her to discover the mysteries that hid in the shadows. With the Amour conspiracy threatening to destroy the very foundation of the monarchy, the detective's resolve became stronger and her determination unyielding. The air crackled with anticipation as Victoria delved deeper into the mystery, her footsteps echoing through the hallowed halls. The Palace of Versailles, once a symbol of absolute power, now stood at the precipice of change. In the ensuing chapters of this unfolding saga, the detective would confront forbidden passions, navigate treacherous alliances, and uncover the hidden truths that could reshape the destiny of a kingdom. Chapter 2: Royal Machinations. The dawn painted the sky in hues of pink and gold, signaling the arrival of a new day at the Palace of Versailles. Detective Victoria Hayes, fueled by the revelations of the previous night, emerged from the shadows with a steely resolve. The grandeur of the palace seemed to loom larger in the morning light, and Victoria felt the weight of her investigation intensify as she delved into the heart of courtly politics. The royal court buzzed with activity as courtiers went about their daily routines, their elaborate attire and polished manners concealing the simmering undercurrent of political intrigue. Victoria moved through the crowd like a ghost, her keen eyes scanning faces for any sign of guilt or complicity. The detective's investigation had uncovered a web of alliances and betrayals that reached the highest echelons of power, and she knew that time was of the essence. In the majestic Hall of Mirrors, where the walls reflected the opulence of the court, Victoria overheard snippets of conversations that hinted at a conspiracy so intricate it threatened to shake the foundations of the kingdom. Noble families whispered behind silk fans, their masked expressions betraying the tension that permeated the air. The detective's instincts told her that she was closing in on the heart of the Amour conspiracy. Her investigation led her to a clandestine meeting in a secluded chamber, where a group of influential figures gathered in the shadows. Victoria concealed herself behind heavy drapes, her breath caught in anticipation as she listened to their hushed discussions. The names of powerful courtiers were mentioned, their roles in the plot becoming clearer with each passing word. Loyalties were tested, alliances forged and broken in the pursuit of power. As Victoria unraveled the intricate threads of the conspiracy, she discovered that it extended beyond the palace walls. The kingdom itself was at stake, and the detective found herself entangled in a game of political chess where every move had consequences. With each revelation, the puzzle pieces fell into place, painting a picture of a plot so diabolical that it threatened not only the current monarch but the very essence of the monarchy itself. The detective's investigation took her to the royal archives, a repository of centuries-old documents that held the secrets of the kingdom. Dust-covered manuscripts revealed a history of clandestine affairs, forbidden loves, and power struggles that had shaped the destiny of the monarchy. Victoria realized that the Amour conspiracy was not an isolated incident but a recurring theme woven into the tapestry of royal lineage. As she dug deeper, Victoria became a pawn in the power struggle that defined courtly life. Loyalties blurred, and the lines between friend and foe became increasingly ambiguous. The detective found herself caught in a web of deceit, where every smile had a motive and every alliance was tinged with betrayal. The stakes rose higher with each passing day, and Victoria knew that her actions could either unravel the conspiracy or plunge the kingdom into chaos. In the midst of the political storm, Victoria discovered a personal connection that added a layer of complexity to her mission. A childhood friend, now entangled in the web of the conspiracy, forced her to confront the blurred lines between duty and personal loyalty. The detective's resolve was tested as she grappled with the conflicting demands of justice and friendship, adding a poignant twist to the unfolding drama. The chapter closed with Victoria standing on the precipice of a revelation that would either expose the Amour conspiracy or plunge the kingdom into turmoil. The grandeur of Versailles, once a symbol of absolute power, now echoed with the footsteps of a detective determined to bring hidden truths to light. As the intricate dance of courtly life continued, Victoria prepared to unveil the next act in this riveting tale of royal machinations. Chapter 3. Forbidden Passions. As the sun dipped below the horizon, casting a warm glow over the Palace of Versailles, Detective Victoria Hayes found herself ensnared in the intricate dance of forbidden passions. The revelations of the previous chapters had led her to the heart of a conspiracy that transcended political machinations, weaving a tapestry of love that defied societal norms. The royal court pulsed with an energy both electric and clandestine as Victoria navigated the sea of masked faces in the grand ballroom. The courtiers, bedecked in extravagant costumes, moved with a grace that masked the undercurrent of desire and treachery. The detective's eyes, sharp and discerning, sought the subtle nuances of forbidden liaisons that played out in the shadows. It was in the moonlit garden, adorned with fragrant blooms and secret alcoves, that Victoria stumbled upon the clandestine affair that would add a new layer of complexity to her investigation. Two figures, their faces hidden by masks, shared stolen glances and whispered words beneath the ancient vines. The detective observed in silence, the weight of their secret love palpable in the air. As Victoria unraveled the threads of this forbidden romance, she discovered that the lovers belonged to rival noble houses, their union deemed unacceptable by the stringent rules of courtly life. The detective's heart, typically guarded by the armor of duty, softened as she witnessed the intensity of their love. The world outside the palace walls may condemn their affair, but within the moonlit garden, their passion defied the constraints of societal expectations. In the ensuing days, Victoria found herself drawn deeper into the complexities of the forbidden love affair. The lovers, burdened by the weight of their secret, sought her assistance in navigating the treacherous waters of courtly life. The detective, torn between duty and empathy, grappled with the moral implications of aiding a love that society deemed unacceptable. The palace became a labyrinth of hidden rendezvous and coded messages, each step taken with the knowledge that discovery could mean ruin for the star-crossed lovers. Victoria, usually a pillar of rationality, found herself entangled in the emotional turmoil of the clandestine affair. The palpable tension in the air mirrored the conflict within the detective's own heart. As the investigation deepened, Victoria discovered that the forbidden passions she witnessed were not isolated incidents but symptomatic of a larger societal struggle. The rigid structure of courtly life, with its rules and expectations, stifled genuine emotions and pushed love into the shadows. The detective became an unwitting advocate for the voiceless, a defender of love against the oppressive forces of tradition and decorum. In the quiet moments between clandestine meetings and coded letters, Victoria allowed herself to reflect on the nature of love itself. The grandeur of Versailles, with its towering spires and gilded halls, seemed to echo with the timeless yearning of hearts that defied societal norms. The detective's own convictions wavered as she questioned the morality of a system that condemned love based on lineage and status. The chapter reached its climax as Victoria stood at the crossroads of duty and empathy. The forbidden passions she had uncovered threatened to consume not only the lovers, but also the delicate balance of the kingdom. The detective faced a choice that would define her legacy: to uphold the rigid traditions of courtly life or to champion the cause of love in the face of adversity. As the moon hung low in the night sky, casting a silver glow over the Palace of Versailles, Victoria Hayes prepared to confront the consequences of forbidden passions. The lovers' fates hung in the balance, and the detective, standing at the epicenter of a love story that defied an empire, braced herself for the tumultuous chapters that lay ahead. Chapter 4. Destiny's Gambit. The Palace of Versailles stood as a silent witness to the swirling currents of fate as Detective Victoria Hayes prepared to unravel the final act of the Amour conspiracy. The echoes of forbidden passions and political machinations reverberated through the grand halls, creating an atmosphere thick with anticipation. As Victoria ventured deeper into the heart of the palace, the stakes soared to unprecedented heights. The detective's investigation took an unexpected turn as she uncovered ancient mysteries that held the key to the kingdom's destiny. The royal archives, shrouded in the dust of centuries, revealed cryptic manuscripts and forgotten prophecies that spoke of a power struggle with far-reaching consequences. Victoria found herself on a quest that transcended the boundaries of time and odyssey through hidden chambers and ancient crypts in pursuit of a truth that could alter the very fabric of reality. The journey led Victoria to forgotten passages beneath the palace, where the walls whispered tales of forgotten dynasties and lost civilizations. The air was heavy with the scent of antiquity, and the detective's footsteps echoed through the dimly lit corridors as she followed the trail of enigmatic symbols that adorned the walls. The mystery deepened, weaving a narrative that intertwined the destinies of the palace's inhabitants with an age-old prophecy. As Victoria delved into the arcane knowledge, she realized that the Amour conspiracy was not merely a product of political intrigue and forbidden passions. It was a manifestation of a cosmic force that sought to redefine the very essence of the kingdom. The detective stood at the crossroads of history, her quest entwining with the fate of the royal lineage in a way she could never have anticipated. The journey through the hidden passages led Victoria to an ancient chamber, its walls adorned with symbols that seemed to pulsate with an otherworldly energy. In the center of the room lay an ancient artifact, a relic that held the key to unlocking the mysteries of the Amour conspiracy. As the detective approached, a surge of power enveloped her, connecting her to a lineage that spanned generations. The artifact revealed a prophecy that foretold a forbidden love that could either bring about the salvation or destruction of the kingdom. Victoria, now a reluctant participant in a cosmic drama, grappled with the weight of her newfound knowledge. The boundaries between past and present blurred as the detective realized that the destinies of the lovers she had uncovered were intricately linked to an ancient legacy. The palace, once a symbol of absolute power, now became the stage for a final showdown between the forces of destiny. Victoria's journey intertwined with the unfolding drama of courtly life, forbidden passions, and cosmic revelations. The detective's actions held the power to tip the scales in favor of love or plunge the kingdom into an abyss of chaos. In a breathtaking climax, Victoria confronted the puppeteers behind the Amour conspiracy, shadowy figures who sought to manipulate the cosmic forces for their own gain. The detective, On with the knowledge of the prophecy and fueled by a newfound sense of purpose, engaged in a battle that transcended the physical realm. The grandeur of Versailles became the battleground for destiny's gambit, where love and power clashed in a symphony of cosmic proportions. As the final threads of the conspiracy unraveled, the palace trembled with the echoes of a shifting destiny. The lovers, whose forbidden passions had sparked the chain of events, stood at the epicenter of a cosmic dance that defied the constraints of time and tradition. Victoria, having played her part in the unfolding saga, witnessed the culmination of a story that spanned centuries. The Palace of Versailles, now bathed in the soft glow of dawn, stood as a testament to the resilience of love and the inexorable force of destiny. The echoes of the Amour conspiracy faded into the annals of history, leaving behind a legacy that would be whispered through the corridors of time. Detective Victoria Hayes, having unveiled the cosmic secrets that bound the kingdom's fate, emerged from the grandeur of Versailles, forever changed by the journey that had taken her beyond the realms of mere mortals.